Welcome to the last part of our series of introductory video presentations on an introduction to ODK, a learning resource compiled by Statistics for Sustainable Development. In this final part, I'm going to show you a little bit more about how to use Kobo Toolbox, specifically focusing on the data monitoring and downloading of data. I'm going to begin by showing you how to navigate Kobo Toolbox's project page a bit more on monitoring data, before finally showing you how to download your collected data ready for data analysis. Over the course of the previous six presentations, we have seen most of the parts of the ODK system. We have seen how to go from the paper survey to your computer by creating your XLS form, and then moving on to the ODK aggregator by uploading your form and creating a project. And then, of course, in the previous part, I showed you how to download the form to your mobile device for data collection, and then how to re-upload this form with completed data back to your ODK aggregator. In this final part, I shall explore the final step of downloading your data to your computer in whichever form, such as a CSV or an XLSX file. Once you have some data downloaded, you can head back online to the Kobo website and download your data for management, data cleaning, analysis, whatever reason you need. You, of course, first need to log back in and find your project. When you do, you will see a summary page, which you can see on the right here. This shows you when your data was collected, how many forms have been submitted, and there are a number of options to the right, which along with the chart are useful for data monitoring. For instance, you can see if data has been submitted before collection should begin by looking at the graph. If I share my screen with you, you'll be able to see some of the details about the project that we have been using. So as you can see, according to the graph, we submitted two data submissions on the 5th of May. We can see that this is when our last data submission was. And we can also see how many submissions in total we have collected. Now, firstly, if I go onto the map page, what I can see here is the GPS locations of data submissions, as well as GPS readings for any variables, if need be. This is especially useful when data is being collected remotely from your location. You can check that data is being collected in locations you would expect and not in strange locations far away from where you're supposed to be collecting data. Next, if I go onto the table section, what I can do here is quickly browse all of the data I have. So as you can see, we have all of our 12 submissions here with our variables along the top using the names as well as the labels. So as you can see, we have the answers to everyone's please enter your name question, their dates of birth. From this, you could check for any unusual looking responses. You could try and see if there are any duplicate entries potentially, or any that look quite incomplete or just in any way look unusual. Additionally, if I go into the reports tab, I can see some small graphs and tables looking into a little bit of data analysis, very basically. As you can see, with only 12 submissions, there's not really a lot to learn here. 7 responses saying they are male, 3 female, and 2 responding other. We have 75% of our respondents saying that they have indeed traveled abroad before, with Germany being the most popular destination of our list of 10 countries, and a little bit of analysis on some numerical variables as well, showing us the mean, median, mode, as well as a standard deviation. That's sort of everything we need to go over in terms of data monitoring. In order to download our data, we can either press the downloads here within the data tab. Although back on summary, you can see that we can also do that from here. From here, you can choose your file format and other options such as inclusion of group names, as well as which versions of the form you want to download data from. For instance, if you have deployed different versions of the form as you've had to make edits as the project has been ongoing, and because of this, earlier data submissions are no longer relevant, you could select only the most recent version of the form to download data from. Once you have chosen these options, including, as you can see, from other form file types that we have. Once we have done this, we can press export. And once this is finished processing, you'll be able to click this button here to download the data to your computer, ready for whatever purpose you require. Now, it is worth mentioning a little bit about how these different file formats actually present their data. This is mainly a point of order when your form contains any repeated groups. In a CSV file, all data will be part of a single CSV file. When this is opened in Excel or other software, all data from the question groupings will appear on the same sheet. Whereas with an XLS file, any repeat groups are arguably more conveniently split into separate sheets within an Excel workbook. Zip files are similar to XLSX in that repeat groups will be split into separate CSV files. This type also has the additional benefit of containing any image, audio, or video files which were a part of the data collection with the zip file. Once you have your data downloaded and saved somewhere useful, you can begin exploring, managing, or analyzing your data in whichever software you see fit, be it R, Stata, or even Excel. This brings us to the end of this series of introductory video presentations on an introduction to Open Data Kit. Throughout this series, we have explored the entire ODK system, starting from your human readable questionnaire through to downloading your final data ready for analysis. We began by creating your XLS form in Microsoft Excel, looking at how to code question types using form logic and a bit on the structure of XLS forms. We then saw how to create your project on an ODK aggregator. Throughout this tutorial, we focused on Kobo Toolbox, but other ODK aggregators will suit your needs just as well. It is all entirely up to you. Then saw how to configure ODK Collect on your mobile device and then use said device for data collection. Then saw how to upload your collected data back to your server, from which you were then able to monitor your data submissions. And finally, as we just looked at, how to download your project data ready for any cleaning you may need to do. And then finally, any analysis you may also need to do. Thank you for looking through this series of presentations. I direct your attention back to, if you remember, at the end of part 4, I linked you various extra resources on how to get started on using XLS forms. This is a good starting point for when you want to use ODK for any project in the future.